most historic part of the United States of America. This is the room where both the Declaration of Independence was debated and signed, and also our Constitution debated and signed. First amendment, of course, from 1776, the second amendment, 1787, as we talked about across the hall. Let me talk a little bit about the arrangement before we get into the details. In those days, I'm talking about the Revolutionary days, if somebody asked where you were from, when you were, you lived in a colony, and somebody asked where you were from, you didn't say I'm an American, necessarily. You wouldn't say I'm a Virginian, or I'm a Delawarean, or a Pennsylvanian. It was no real feel for a nation, per se. It was a colonial feel, because that's the way the country was arranged at that time. So we think, we're fairly certain that the arrangement would have been this way for the Constitutional Convention. And we're fairly certain that the Second Continental Congress that I spoke about would start meeting in this room. It was arranged this way too. Meeting had started basically geographically with the New England states, Massachusetts, Rhode Island, New Hampshire, and this would be Delaware over here. Over here would be New Jersey and New York. Don't tell me, I can't tell you exactly which state was which, but I know they were in this area. This would be the host table, which would be the Pennsylvania delegation. This would be the Virginia delegation. These two are particularly important when it came to the Constitutional Convention. I'll talk about that. An adequate job, and I want to thank you guys for your rapt attention and your questions. And if you have no other questions, please exit to the left. I appreciate it. Thanks very much. You're welcome.